in order to download any software in the specific location, we need to modify browser setting. In order to download any software into a specific location, we need to set one simple setting in the browser. Let us see what it is. Go to the top right vertical three bars. You can see top right vertically three bars. Click on this. Go to settings. Everybody. Top right vertical three bars, then settings. In the settings, you can see advanced, left side advanced. In the left side, click on advanced. Under advanced, you can see downloads. In the downloads, asked where each file should be saved while downloading. Ask where to save each file before downloading. This should be enabled. If at all it is not enabled, then by default it will be downloading into downloads folder. It will be downloading into downloads folder. You can see downloads. It should be enabled. This is the first step. Everybody enable. Let us see second one, softwares downloads. The first one, JDK. The second one, WinRAR. Third one, Edit Plus. These three softwares very much required for every beginner. Every beginner should require JDK, WinRAR, Edit Plus. Let us download one by one. Before downloading, create one folder for the downloads. In the E drive, I created one folder with a name as July Batch Softwares. All softwares I will be downloading into this folder. Come on. Try creating one folder for all the downloads. All these three softwares I will be downloading into this folder. Try creating a folder. While creating a folder, don't go for any uppercase alphabets, any spaces. No space, no uppercase alphabet. No space, no uppercase alphabet. Inside this folder, try downloading. In my system, already I have downloaded all three softwares. I'll show you one more time. These are the three softwares we are going to download. First and foremost one, JDK. From where and how we have to download? Guys, everybody. In the Google Chrome, in the same tab or in the new tab, go to Oracle. Oracle.com. In the same tab or in the different tab, Oracle.com, everybody. In the Oracle.com, you have to look for products. While clicking on products, you are getting Oracle Cloud for government, autonomous database. Just press up arrow, featured products, up arrow, you can see Java, Under products, through up arrow, you can find Java. Click on Java. Through up arrow, we are finding Java. Click on Java. Download Java. You can see top right, download Java. Click on this download Java. Everybody click on download Java. In the download Java, you can see Oracle JDK, Oracle JDK, then JDK download link. Click on JDK download, not the documentation download. You have to click on JDK download. Click on JDK download. Click on JDK download. Come down, down, down. Keep coming down, 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 down. 64 compressed archive. The last one, Windows 64 compressed archive. Click on the selected link. There is a link which will be downloading a zip file. That is a compressed format of Windows 64. Compressed format of Windows 64. Click on this. Check the checkbox. Then click on download JDK. Click on download JDK and choose the folder whatever created. I created a folder with the name of JDK July Batch Surface. This is the folder. Go inside this folder. Try downloading. Same software already available in my system. I'm clicking cancel. You should click on save. Save the JDK into the folder whichever we have created. I'm canceling this operation, but you have to go for save. Once JDK downloaded, try downloading WinRAR. Try downloading WinRAR. win-rar.com. Open a browser. Type win-rar.com. Download WinRAR. Download WinRAR. Download WinRAR. You can see the bottom. Choose the same location. Whatever location we have created July batch softwares, in the same location, try downloading WinRAR also. Try downloading WinRAR also. Click on save. I'm cancelling this as I already have this. The next software is Edit Plus. Go for editplus.com. The website is editplus.com. Click on download Edit Plus. Click on download Edit Plus. Again, you can look for download Edit Plus. Again, choose the same software folder, July batch software folder. Everybody. Click on save. It is already available in my system and canceling the same operation. All three softwares downloading got over. Let us install installation. Edit Plus and WinRAR, both are application files you have to install explicitly. Let me install Edit Plus. Simple. Everybody. It's already installed in my system. I can install one more time. Edit Plus, double click, it's application file, exe file, EPP, double click, click on accept, click on yes, start to copy. Setup got over. Click OK. Edit Plus installation very simple. It's an application file, exe file. Double click on EPP 540. Keep going next to next. OK, OK. That's all. No need of bothering anything with respect to Edit Plus installation. Very similarly, even WinRAR installation also. WinRAR installation also, it's application file, double click on it, keep going, next, next, OK, OK. Double click on it, click on yes, click on install, click OK. Once you click OK, a new Windows Explorer will open. Done. A new file is, window is opening. Just to close this window. WinRAR installation, very simple. It's got installed. Fully, it's got installed. Third one. JDK installation. JDK installation. It is very simple. As we got zip file, you need to extract the zip file. Compressed file should be extracted. Compressed file should be extracted. Try extracting it. How we can extract? By using WinRAR. Right click on compressed downloaded JDK file. Right click on JDK 16.0.1. Then go for extract to. Select extract to. Everybody. extract to. Automatically you are getting one folder. This folder containing the complete content of zipped file. Zipped file content extracted into a folder by using WinRAR. How we have done this? Just right click on zip file, extract to JDK 1601. You'll get automatically one folder. This folder containing complete JDK. You can see one more folder, JDK. Go inside this folder. Inside this folder, Java binaries, Java libraries, lot more. Bin stands for binary. Go inside a binary folder. Inside a binary folder, you can see several application files, binary files, lot more are there. You can treat these are the command files. Command files. These command files we have to run from the command prompt. To run these command files from the command prompt, from C drive, from D drive, from E drive, from F drive, you need to update path environment variable. By using path environment variable, we can specify location of commands. I repeat once again. By using path environment variable, we can update location of commands to the command prompt. We are telling to the command prompt where commands are there through path environment variable. Through path environment variable, we will be specifying location of the commands to the command prompt. So this is the location of the commands. Select address bar. Copy this. This location should be updated inside a path environment variable. This location should be updated in the path environment variable. You should know why do we require path environment variable. By using path environment variable, we are updating commands locations to the command prompt. Commands locations to the command prompt. Copy. After copying this location, left side you can see this PC or my PC in the same window. In the same window, left side you can see this PC or my PC. Right click on this PC or my PC. You can find properties. Click on properties. Advanced system settings. Click on advanced system settings. Click on environment variables. Environment variables. In my system, only path is there in the upper section. Check it out whether path is there in the upper section. If path is there in the upper section, then you can modify by selecting path and clicking on edit. Go to the new, specify copied place as a one entry. We are specifying several commands locations. Bin of JDK is one commands location. Likewise, any number of commands locations, if already available. I'll show you once again. If path is there in the upper section, don't bother about the lower section. Already path is there in the lower section. Lower section using by operating system, you should not modify lower section. Try considering upper section. If already path is there, select path, click on edit. Select path, click on edit. Go to the new. Go to the new. The last one, last blank line, control V. If already path is there, then keep clicking OK, OK in all the windows. If path is already there in the upper section, follow this. If path already there, select the path, click on edit, go to new, control V. Then click OK in all the files. Click OK in all the files. Assume there is no path in your system in the upper section. There is no path in your system in the upper section. Click on new. First new, not the second new. Don't bother about second new, edit and delete. You should not consider second new, delete and edit. Consider first new. As path is not there, then go for new. Specify name as a path. With any case, lower case or upper case. Name as a path, variable value, whatever you copied. Then keep clicking OK in all the windows. Keep clicking OK in every window. Already updated path in my system. I am clicking cancel. All windows I am cancelling. But you have to click OK after updating path. So completely path environment variable updation got over. Maybe you can consider this as a configuration. In the configuration, path environment variable updating. You can specify lower case or upper case env variable. We updated path environment variable. After updating a path environment variable, to check whether updating is proper or not, open command prompt. Go to the left bottom of type here to search. So typing cmd, you'll get a command prompt. Open this command prompt. Let us trigger Java C command to know the version of our Java C. Java command to know the version of Java. If we get this message, then path environment variable updation is very proper. Path environment variable is very proper. Path environment variable is very proper. Path environment variable is very proper. done. Path environment variable is very proper. Now let us develop a Hello World development simple Java program. I can say Hello World development. In this Hello World development, totally three steps are there. First and foremost one, composing a program. Composing a Java program. Second one, compilation. Third one, running. Let us see these three steps one by one. In order to compose a Java program, you should require a location where you have to compose. Composing is nothing but developing or writing or typing a program. Best term is compose. Composing a program rather than developing a program or typing a program. Go to the E drive or any drive. Create one folder where you supposed to develop Java programs. Don't use the folder whichever created for software's downloading purpose. Whichever folder you already created for software's downloading purpose, don't use the same. Go for another folder for development. For development purpose, I created one folder with a name as July Batch DB. July Batch DB. Whenever you are creating a folder, don't go for uppercase alphabets, don't go for any spaces, go inside, try developing a Java file. I already developed hello.java. While compiling, we got hello.class. I will be using same location to compose Java program. To compose a Java program, create one development directory. We have a directory, let us create it. Let us compose a Java program. To compose the Java program, everybody, to compose the Java program, we had to use edit place. Go to the desktop, everybody. In the desktop, you can see edit this. In the desktop, you can see the edit this. In the desktop, you can see the edit this. Click on, double click on edit this. Double click on edit plus. Click on yes. Click on OK. After clicking OK, everybody, you will be getting one pop-up window where you can see trial. Click on trial. Then click on I agree. You have to click on trial, then I agree. You will be getting a 30 days trial version. Before 30 days, I will be giving a key in order to make it production version. So initially you can go for I agree. It will come 30 days. Before 30 days itself, I will be providing a key. Now, after opening edit list, put the file new Java. File new Java, everybody. You will be getting automatically automatically the default content. It is a default content. You require only class name. I am choosing class name as Hello Atai. There is a class Hello in my development. I am choosing a class with a name as Hello Atai. Whenever class name you are choosing, the class name first letter should be in the uppercase. If two words are there, second word first letter also should be in the uppercase. You can see. Now, use this type of class names. Please note down, class name always should start with uppercase. If two words are there, second word first letter uppercase. If three words are there, second word, third word, first letter should be in the uppercase. First letter anyhow should be in the uppercase. This is the convention you have to follow. It is the name of the class. If four words are there, second word, first letter uppercase, third word, first letter uppercase, fourth word, first letter uppercase, anyhow, starting character uppercase. This is what the convention we are following. Now copy the class name. Copy the class name. I copied class name. Control S, save this file. Control S. Choose the location whichever you already created. Come on guys. July batch DEV. This should be the location. Location should be whatever folder you created. Then file name should be class name only. That is why we copied class name already. Go for control B. File name should be class name. File name should be class name. Location should be July batch DEV. Click on save. This entire process is composing. We compose a simple, Java program. Composing is done. Where we have composed? In one directory. What is the directory? You can see. This is the directory. E drive July batch DEV. This is the Java file. We developed a Java file in the composing step. Composing step resulting a Java file. Address bar content. Copy the address bar content through the Java file location or select the address bar content. Select the address bar content, everybody. Select the address bar content. Selecting address bar content. CMD. Everybody type CMD. Type CMD. Press enter. This is the location where Java file is available. From this location only, we have to trigger Java C command. Java C space. Right click and paste. You can see class name. Class name already copied. With the class name only, file name is saved with the extension as Java. In case of Java, every file extension is .java extension. Press enter. Java C space. Hello again dot Java. This is the compilation step. Compilation step generating class file. Go to the July batch DEV. We developed hello again dot Java. We got hello again dot class. Come on. Java C command generating a class file. Java C command generating a class file. Compilation step is completely got over. Compilation step is completely got over. Let's move to running. Let's move to running, everybody. Running also very simple. Very simple. Trigger Java command space right click. Java space name of the class. It will be looking for a class file whichever generated by Java C command. Press enter. You can see hello world. All three steps we have seen. Let me show one more development, one more project, sorry, one more program development. Everybody, open edit place. Already edit place is available. Everybody go to file, new Java. I'm choosing class name as hello again. One more time. You can see multiple words are there. Please observe the format of choosing a class name with multiple words. Every word first letter keep in the uppercase. I'm not changing anything. I'm just choosing a class name with more words. Copy this class name. Save it. Control S. Choose the location. July batch DEV. July batch DEV. Choose the file name as a class name. Click on save. Click on save. Now open the same command prompt. No need of different one. Java C space right click dot Java. You can see the class file. Class file developed by Java C command. Now trigger Java command to run the same class file. Java space right click. Whatever class name you copied into the clipboard, save is displayed.